or anything to the pastor, and he just wouldn't come back. Well, finally, had no other alternative. The pastor had to bring him before the church and had to remove him from the membership of the church. And that's still biblical, by the way.
Right.
Had to exercise church discipline on him because of his sin and the reproach that he was bringing upon the church. And you know, it wasn't long after that, and I'm telling you a true story, it was not long after that at all, he began to have some physical complications. He went to the doctor, they ran some tests, and they broke the news to him, "Sir, you are eat up in cancer. And said it's terminal, you're not going to make it. You only have so long to live, you're not going to make it." And he got right back to church, I guarantee you. You know, the rod of God has, the chastening rod of God has a way of getting your attention.
Yes, sir.
He was right back in church the next Sunday after finding out. Got right with God, got right with the church, got right with the pastor, got right with the one in the church who he was offended with. And began to be a great Christian, but he was eat up in cancer. I was just a young boy in those days. I can remember going to his house and having what they would call a cottage prayer meeting, and all of his family would come, and we'd have singing, and the pastor would preach, and people would be weeping under conviction, and God was moving and using his life as a testimony. But one thing I will never forget, if God lets me live to be 100, he stood up one Sunday. He was so weak he could barely hold on to the back of the pew. And he said, "Pastor, I want to say a word." He said, "Go ahead, brother." And he's sitting there trembling. He's so weak he can barely stand. And he said, "I want to thank God for cancer." Are you hearing me this morning? He said, "I want to thank God for cancer. Because God has used this affliction in my life to get my attention and get me back in fellowship with God." What are you saying, preacher? I'm saying chastisement accompanies true salvation. If you're saved by the grace of God, you're not going to drag his name through the mud. You will be chastened. He will deal with you. And it won't be pretty. It won't be pretty. My friend, if you can live in sin and enjoy it, and God not chastening you, you can mark it down, you are not a legitimate child of God. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 13:5, I'm wrapping it up, examine yourselves whether you be in the faith. Prove your own self. So I encourage you, examine yourself. And I believe you can examine yourself based on these four things I made mention of this morning. Was there ever any conviction in your life? Was the Holy Spirit drawing you? Was there a conversion that took place? Was there a continuous? Did it last? And is there a chastisement if you do wrong? So I encourage you, examine yourself and see if these things accompany your salvation experience. Make sure you got the real thing, because eternity is too long to gamble. Amen. Richard, thank you. Thank you so much.